Hey guys, it's Leanne from Healthful Pursuit, and this is another mini-sode of the Keto Diet Podcast. Today's extras and transcript can be found at healthfulpursuit.com/podcast/x15. And we have regular episodes of the podcast every Sunday, so be sure to check those out. I interview a bunch of different people. And if you're part of our Keto Unlimited Club, which you can find more at theketounlimited.com. Not only do you get the podcast episodes, but you get the video portion of the episodes. You get to see myself and the guest interact over video, and there's also no ads, and you get it a day early. So be sure to head on over to theketounlimited.com if you want to check that out. There's lots of bonuses. We used to call it our Patreon page, but that sounds boring. So we changed it to Keto Unlimited because that's way better. I feel like, who knows? Today I wanted to chat with you guys about sugar. It's September 19th. It's a little ways off from Halloween, but I have some pretty fun stuff planned for Halloween for the mini-sodes. So I wanted to talk about sugar way ahead of time. So maybe if Halloween is approaching and you're like, dang, I just need an episode to like tell me it's okay. Hey, here's the episode. I'm like a month and a bit early. Okay, sugar. I love sugar. You know, I'm not one of those people that like stops eating sugar forever and then hate sugar. I think I'll always love sugar. And I'm not talking about like candies. I've really moved on from that. I've done some really, really awesome work these last couple of years on ditching my love of candy, mostly because it makes me constipated. TMI, meh, whatever. It's a health podcast. Deal with it. Poo. But, you know, when it comes to sugar and just sweet things, I like sweet things. And I think it would be ridiculous for me to say, don't worry, guys, I've been keto for 5 years. And after this, I don't even care about sugar. Somebody can wave a cookie in my face. And I'm like, whatever, man. No, man, I'm going to eat that cookie. Like, it. I mean, my addiction to sugar has definitely gotten a lot better. Not necessarily, I think, because why has it gotten better? I think it really has to do with my mental state. It's like, I could eat that candy because candy's my thing. I could eat that candy and be constipated for like 2 weeks, or I could get an apple and enjoy it, put some cinnamon on there, maybe some coconut butter, enjoy that and not be constipated. And also my scalp gets pretty itchy when I eat candy, and my scalp doesn't get itchy with an apple. So it's all like you take some, you lose some, you win some, you gain some. So I think for you, you know, if you're still struggling with sugar, Halloween's coming up and you're like, blah, I don't know how to deal with this. I'm going to fall off plan. Maybe don't set yourself up for failure by thinking you're a failure or thinking that there's either like a win or lose to all the situation. If you have the candy, your life will go on. It's fine. And you can learn from it, grow from it, understand what happens so that you can set yourself up for success, or I don't want to say success. You can set yourself up for a more grounded approach the next time around. I know that I will never be totally free and clear of just loving carbs. I do love carbs. I like the way they make me feel. I like being able to eat them when I'm out with friends, and that's my life, and I'm okay with that. Do I feel better when I eat keto? 100%. But then there are times where I just know that I need carbs. And so I would encourage you, you know, as sugar becomes a bigger part of your life, especially into October, head on over to healthfulpursuit.com/sugar. I've put together like a little PDF download. That's free. You can just check it out. It gives a bunch of steps on how to ditch sugar more frequently. I'm not going to say for good, but I think it's really important that we be honest with ourselves, especially, you know, health coaches and things like that, when they say, and then insert diet here. And then I ate raw vegan for 3 months and I never craved sugar again. It's like, whoa, are you telling the truth? Really? Do you mean to tell me that like when you're at a movie, you're not just going to buy licorice and eat that? Seriously? I mean, I really like to be honest with myself. And I think that that's probably like the best medicine to fully understanding your body and also healing your body. When we become more conscious to what's actually happening and we're not lying to ourselves or fibbing to others, I think we're better able to make lasting change. I find like I eat way, 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 way. I don't even know the last time I ate candy, actually. I'm trying to think. I think the last time I had candy was probably 3 months ago. because I just don't care. And I know that for me, it's like, I just don't feel good when I eat it. So I'm choosing not to eat it. But if I went into it of like, no, I'm keto, I don't eat candy, guaranteed I'd have it once a week. So I hope that that was helpful and that you head on over to healthfulpursuit.com/sugar if you're having challenges with sugar, and I'll share some tips with you. And I will see you guys on Sunday. Bye.
Thanks for listening to the Keto Diet Podcast. Join us again next Sunday to discover more Keto for Women secrets for your fat-fueled life. The Keto Diet Podcast, including show notes and links, provides information in respect to healthy living, recipes, nutrition, and diet, and is intended for informational purposes only. The information provided is not a substitute for medical advice, diagnosis, or treatment, nor is it to be confused as such. We cannot guarantee that the information provided on the Keto Diet Podcasts reflects the most up-to-date medical research. Information is provided without any representations or warranties of any kind. Please consult a qualified physician for medical advice, and always seek the advice of a qualified healthcare provider with any questions you may have regarding your health and nutrition program.